Lives are complex. None of us live in a vacuum. We're affected by our environment, and when one piece of our lives isn't working, it ripples to others. We see this all the time in the United States. Lives are complicated. It's all connected. It's all connected. It's the same in underdeveloped nations too. Poverty and marginalization have a lot of causes. It isn't just one thing that's keeping people in places like Myanmar, Tanzania, and Ukraine from thriving and owning their futures. That means solutions have to be complex too. They have to take everything into account. It's what organizations like PACT call integrated development, where you don't just say, this community is struggling with a particular disease, so we're gonna go treat that. Or this ecosystem isn't doing well, so we're gonna restore it and leave. That's all good stuff, but it's the big picture that really matters. That's what creates lasting change in people's lives. So you start by looking at what's really going on. You talk to the community and you really listen. What's really behind the poverty there? Maybe there's a lot of sickness in the community and you thought the problem was they needed sanitation infrastructure. But it turns out they also lack clinics and health workers, and parents don't understand what a difference good nutrition and preventative health care can make for their kids. And even if they did, they don't have the money for things like healthy food and transportation to a health clinic because they don't have the skills they need to earn a dignified living. Now you're looking at the big picture. You're saying, what can we do to tackle all of these things? How can we make sure what we do lasts? So you start mothers groups throughout community. You teach women in the groups how to start their own microbanks so they have access to credit, and you give them training to start their own small businesses too. Soon, they're raising crops and making money. Then maybe you recruit some volunteers to be community health workers, and you start working with the local government and local nonprofits, helping them to build up local public services that will keep going after you leave. Maybe the moms groups will keep going too. They'll bring in new members when the old ones graduate. Now, kids are healthier, people have more money, and they're using it for better food, to improve their housing, to educate the children, and to save for emergencies. The community is working together. They're solving their own problems. Maybe some new problem comes up that they weren't expecting, but it's okay, because they don't need you anymore. They got it.